Bernie and Mario's mission to rescue a classic Mercedes SL is heading downhill.
Great car, U-Boat. It's got no bloody drive.
Mario's eagerness to make the deal didn't give Bernie the time he needed to examine the car, and they've ended up with a potential death trap.
It's rotten, Mario. Mind your hands.
With a week already gone on a tight four-week schedule, if there's the slightest chance the Mercedes can be rescued and turn a profit, the boys are going to grab at it. But the only way to know for sure involves even more work stripping the car back to its bare bones.
That's gone completely.
It's had it, innit? Seen better days.
It's even worse than Bernie feared. The entire bulkhead of the Mercedes is completely rotten.
If we had 6 months to do it, maybe you got half a chance, but not in the time we've got. No way. And that would never be safe.
The SL is no longer a financially viable option. They've already spent $7,000, and saving it would shatter their $20,000 budget.
Oh, man, where the f*** are you going? Fuck, about as much use as a bleating chocolate teacup is.
Bernie might not know where Mario's going, but everyone knows where the Mercedes is heading, a one-way trip to the scrapyard. And with it, the entire restoration project. It's been 2 days since they scrapped the Mercedes, but Mario hasn't been sitting around twiddling his thumbs. He's taken matters into his own hands to try and save the project and his pride.
Whoa.
Hey, hold it there.
What's this, Mario?
I bought another car.
I hear a commotion. Pop my head around the corner. There's Mario and all the guys pushing this car in. What the hell's it? Where did he get this one from?
I remember seeing this sort of green one for sale.
I looked at it, it was missing some pieces, but it was in good shape, so I bought it and shipped it over. It's beautiful.
Yeah, Mario, I think you and me need to have a quiet word, son. Sorry, Daniel.
Word, yeah, all right. Yeah, we then need I'll to have pop a quiet the hood, word. See what it needs. Yeah, what's up?
What's the story?
Here's the story. I got it for a little bit more than we paid for the last one, and the
how
first...
do you know it runs? I don't know where he got it from, how much he's paid for it.
Between me and you and the brick wall, I gave her £3,000. It was a good deal. The car kind of runs. She said it ran. She did a bunch of work to it, so she said. And I liked it.
There's no hard top. There's no soft top.
Listen, leave it to me. We're going to take all the bits from the other burgundy one, and we're going to put it on this car.
When's the last time the car ran?
3 years ago. It'll run. I have a good feeling on it.
You know, haven't we wasted enough time? It don't run. There's no roof.
We got the roof. We'll get it from...
Time. Can't we get one car that we can start up and it drives in the damn workshop?
This will be it, once they get it started.
But knowing Mario, he's got a deal. What sort of a deal he's got on that car, I don't know until I have a proper look at it.
Mario's confident, though, about his decision to buy the second SL because he knows Mercedes of this vintage are becoming highly collectible and increasing in value by the day. The SL may have had its heyday in the 80s, but its winning combination of sleek good looks and power under the hood means it still has a legion of appreciative fans today.
The car's a 1987 420 SL.
I decided to put a diesel engine in it. Not a standard fitting for this car at all.
This is my 420 SL, very nice engine, 0-60 about 8.5 seconds, 135 miles an hour.
A mint-condition SL can fetch more than $50,000, but if it follows in the tire tracks of its predecessor, the Pagoda, which is now selling for over $100,000, they could be onto the next big thing. The escalating prices might help explain why the annual SL Day is becoming so popular. Well, popular with most of those attending.
The car just come first, and I'm very much second. There's lots of hours spent in the garage polishing and doing everything. Yeah, lonely. I think that's a good word. Lonely and patient.
Well, my wife thinks I spent £2,000 on it, but I probably really spent about £9,000 on it. Don't put that bit in.
Mario's second Mercedes is up on the ramp, and it looks like he's screwed up again. It's got almost as much rust as the first one. But unlike the first Mercedes, its rot won't make it a death trap.
I noticed straight away some rot on the front and rear of both front wings and again on the front of the rear quarters and along the sills. Just thank our lucky stars we're not trying to put a new bulkhead into the other one.
Mario's second chance Mercedes is salvageable, just, but it's still a lot of work. And with only 3 weeks left of the original schedule, bodywork expert Nick is going to be pushed to his limits. His first job will be to remove the rust by cutting back to the sound metal. He'll then need to cut and fabricate each new panel individually before welding them into place. Mario may have saved the project, but he's already spent almost $17,000 of the $20,000 budget. Bernie wants to make it clear that there's a long way to go before they have a chance of turning a profit.
Nick, show him exactly what he's bought here.
Which part of it?
Ah, it's a little rusty.
A little? Have a look.
It's gone from just doing the front corner on that side to every corner of it. The other side, I've done the outer and the inner wheel arch. And this side, you think, it's a little bit better down the front here. But you get up to the back and we've got to put, you know, a quarter of a boot section in it.
It's rotten, Mario.
This is the business we're in. We got to fix it.
Yeah, just we can do it. But, you know, the time schedules that you put on things and then expect us to still be able to get them done in time, it's just becoming more and more unrealistic. Hey, we could probably do with a bit more time on this one.
Okay,
I can't work a miracle.
I'll see what I can do.
If we can't get it, I'm not cutting any corners.
I don't want you to cut any corners. I want it done right.
Good.
Nick, I have faith in you.
Faith's good, but extra time would have been better.
Can we make the car look great and restore it back to what its former glory? Absolutely. Can we do it in a time frame that was originally set? Not a hope in hell.
Nick may have a point. The deadline is desperately tight, and with the first car scrapped, so is the budget. But Mario's come up with a solution that should help on the money side of things. He's taking a leaf out of parts dealer Frank's book. Cannibalizing the written-off Mercedes will save a fortune in parts, including the soft and hard tops and the hood.